As a data analyst, you've been called by the marketing team because they're worried about losing customers, okay? And as an analyst, they want you to work out why they're losing customers and if there's anything you can do about it. Now, you may or may not hear the term, but they'll talk about churn, and so they'll say, can you build a churn model? As a data analyst, if you've been asked to build a churn model, what is a churn model? Essentially, a churn model is a model that can predict when someone's going to leave your business, okay? So when a customer's no longer going to be your customer. Now, churn models are usually typically good where you have some kind of subscription or someone registers for you for your services and then unregisters or stops buying, okay? So there's a gap between when they buy, but you know who they are, okay? You can't run a churn model on people you don't know, okay? So you can only run a churn model on people who identify themselves with you. So this is either a subscription business, it's either that they create an account with you, or it could be that they are part of a loyalty program. That's where you can build a churn model. So if the business asks you to build a churn model, you need to first ask, do you have like customers that we can track, okay? Because if you can't track the customer's purchases over time, you can't build the churn model. So once you've established that you can track the customer that they have a subscription with you, or they have to create an account with you, or that they're part of a loyalty program, the next thing is to work out when is someone no longer a customer. Now that may seem like an easy question, okay? But it's not always the case. Now a subscription service might be fine, because if it's a monthly subscription or even an annual subscription, when they don't renew, how do you know that they're no longer a customer? In that one, you know they're no longer a customer because they didn't renew, okay? So you can easily say, okay, if they don't renew, they're no longer a customer. But let's take a loyalty program. I go to a department store, I take a loyalty card out, I shop for a couple of months, and then they never see me again. How do they know that I've churned? How do they know that I'm no longer a loyal customer for them, okay? So that's the first thing you need to define. And that's not something that you can do statistically. I mean, you could look at it and say, look, on average, 50% of people stop transacting after 12 months. So therefore, we're going to say our definition of churn is anyone who doesn't transact after 12 months, okay? But usually you need to make it a business decision. So if you're like a department store, 12 months might be fine because you expect to see people once or twice a year, okay? When I worked with department stores data, I found that, you know, people were spending on average 3 to 4 times a year they were going to a department store. So having 12 months was a good number. But if you're a grocer or like a supermarket, okay, 12 months is too long, okay? Typically, you'd say if they've not come back to you in 4 weeks, ideally, if they've not come back to you in 2 weeks, okay? People usually shop every week, okay? So you could technically say 2 weeks, but you would probably want to be on the safe side and say, let's say 4 weeks, because let's say they go off on a 2 week holiday. You don't want to suddenly say they've churned when actually they've gone away for 2 weeks on holiday. So you might want to say 4 weeks is your window. Now, what happens is the opposite of churn is active. So if they're either an active customer or they're a lapsed customer or an inactive customer, there's some differentiation between lapsed and inactive, but let's just say you have an active and you have an inactive customer. It's when they become inactive, that's when you need to build a churn model. And what essentially you're doing is you're trying to work out when someone churned, and what you're trying to do is predict it as early as possible. So let's say I'm a subscription business, that's the easiest one, and I'm a 12-month subscription business, so you have to pay for sign up for 12 months, okay? And let's take it as a TV service, okay? So Sky is a good example. So Sky, you know, you need to subscribe for 12 months minimum. I think it's 18 months now, but let's say it's 12 months, okay? So whatever it is, let's say it's a subscription business and that I need to subscribe for 12 months, okay? So what happens is there's no point telling the business at month 11, oh, this person's going to leave, because they've only got a month, or even in month 12, they've only got a month to do something, and it's very hard to change someone's mind after 12 months. You're just going to state the obvious. The ideal thing is in month one to be able to predict that they're going to churn in 12 months' time, okay? So you might look at the data and go, actually, someone who subscribed to our TV service, for example, in the first 30 days, they don't watch many movies, okay? They just typically watch TV shows, they log in only in the evenings, and then and those people are more likely to churn. So now you've got something to do. You can build a model based on what people do in the first 30 days. Now, you may not have enough data in 30 days, so it could be 60, 90 days, whatever. But let's say even if it's 90 days, 3 months, so you've got 9 months, 3 months worth of data, and you're looking at the kind of differences between people. So you might look at how often they view TV, how often they go to help sections, how often they call customer service, how often they change channels, whatever data you have, okay? You get all that data, okay? And then you try and predict if any of those attributes, any of those data predicts churn in 12 months. So after 12 months, do they leave you? Do they no longer subscribe to you? And here, typically, you'd use something like a decision tree, okay? Because you're looking at a dichotomous outcome. They either subscribe or they don't subscribe, okay? So you probably want to use some kind of decision tree and put all those variables in. Like I said, the earlier you can predict it, the better it is for the business. So let's say I could predict after 3 months with 80% accuracy or 90% accuracy that someone is going to leave us, okay? So now the business has 9 months to convince them not to leave, okay? So if your model's accurate, it means that for every 10 people they target, 2 would have stayed, but 8 would have left, okay? So that's not bad, okay? So they have 9 months now to change those people's mind. Now, let's say they offer a discount, okay? That's still good, because they, if that discount rescued half of those people, of the half, one might have stayed anyway, but 4 wouldn't have stayed, so therefore it would have been worth giving that discount, because you'd have to spend that money reacquiring. So the business might work out that the cost of acquisition is £100, but actually if we offer someone a £50 discount, it's much better than acquiring. It's better to keep an existing customer than to reacquire a new customer. Now, obviously, if you can predict churn within a month of them joining, that's brilliant, because now the business has 11 months to convert them, and in the first 6 months, they might decide to say, send promotions and say, don't forget, there's a brilliant TV show on, go and watch this. Or they might say, you know what, this show is on, you love it, go and watch this. Or they might say, you know, we have TV, sports channels, come subscribe to our sports channel, which will get people hooked on because they want to watch more and more of their team playing. So, but whatever they do, the business has an opportunity to do it. So if you as an analyst have been asked by the business to build a churn model or to investigate churn, that's essentially what they're talking about. They're talking about, can you use the data to predict when someone's going to leave you in the future, okay? Because then that gives them a window of opportunity, okay, to do something about it so that they can retain that person. Because it is always more cost effective to retain someone than it is to acquire someone. So that's what churn means. And in the context of analytics, it's usually a churn model people are referring to. So there's two things, like I said, you have to do. One is define what is churn. So when does someone churn? Like I said, if it's a subscription model with a fixed period, then it's the fixed period, whether it's 12 months, 1 month. But if it's like a retail or a loyalty program where you don't know, then you've got to define that yourself, either through the data or agree it with the business or through logic, okay? If you know that you're a grocer, people shop every week at a grocer, then maybe if they haven't shopped with you for 4 weeks, then they become inactive, therefore they've churned, okay? So whatever it is. And the second part is, what data do you have to predict that? So like I said, you know, if it's a TV company, you might look at what they watch, you know, how often they watch, how long, all that kind of stuff. But you also, you may have data on them, so who they are, where they live, you know, you may be able to get third-party data and append it to find out how much they earn, if they've got kids, because, you know, you may find that someone subscribed to something and they've got kids in their household, so you can check if kids is a predictor of churn. If it is, then you could promote kids shows and keep them on, okay? But you need that data, and the earlier you can predict it. So if you think about it, if you get a group of customers that churn, okay, go back 12 months of their data, go back 12 months as though it's their first month or their second month or their third month, and look at what they do, and then see if in 12 months time they churn or not, and that's how you build the model. And those models will typically be built using decision trees, okay? And you know, things like Chade, Cart, Random Forest, all those kind of stuff that you could use to build churn. So, you know, so that's really what churn is. So as a data analyst, I hope this video explains to you what churn is. And so if you come across that term and the business wants you to do something about churn, they're typically asking you to build a churn model so they can prevent churn and rescue, keep customers. Well, I hope you found that useful. If you want to know more about churn or churn models, please ask questions in the comment section below. If you want to know about other terms that you come across as a data analyst, please also ask them in the comment section below. Please obviously do share and like the video. And of course, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.